UP Championship, we continued today with four championship trophies up for grabs. The Division II and III UP Golf Finals were held in three different locations. The D2 Finals were at the George Young Golf Course in Iron County, while the D3 Finals were held at two different courses in Delta County. Let's begin the Highland Golf Club in Escanaba, where the D3 boys meet was held. I caught up with the boys on the par 5 sixth hole. Sam Ebert of Cedarville had a birdie putt and the ball stops right before it goes in. Ebert would tap that in for par. Hunter Eichhorn of Carneynado drove the green in two. His eagle putt was long, but he would knock in the putt from there for birdie. Forrest MacArthur of Ingenine had a chance to save par, and the ball did everything but go home and stay home. MacArthur would have to settle for a six on hole six. Blending in with the tree is where we find Tyler Bailey of Jeffers. From a tough angle, Bailey hits a perfect chip shot as the ball nuzzles up close to the pin. After having a tough time on long par 5, mid-pen's Wade Tryon had a long downhill putt, and he makes it look easy. Jacob Kaminsky of Rudyard was trying to save par, and his fourth shot would enable him to do so. As the ball stops 2 feet from the hole, Kaminsky would tap it in from there. Looking at the team results, Jeffers edged Cedarville by 2 strokes to take home the Division III title. Carneynado finished in third place. Carneynado's Hunter Eichhorn and Cedarville's Sam Eberts both shot a 71. Eichhorn won medalist honors on the second playoff hole. Not too bad for a true freshman. A 15-minute drive from Highland takes us next to the Escanaba Country Club for the D3 girls meet on the par 4 first. That's where I caught up with the girls. Savannah Stenberg would find her way out of the trees and onto the green, and the Bark River Harris golfer was the medalist in the day with a 91. Annie Eberts of Cedarville was just off the green, and her chip shot burned the left edge there of the hole. She finished in a fifth place tie with 97. Forest Park's Hannah Marinoff was 25 yards from the pin on one. Her approach shot hits the front part of the hole and somehow misses the flag stick. File that in the something you don't see everyday department. Cassidy Kamenberg of Big Bay Dinac was just off the green, so she decides to bump and run it, which proved to be a nice call there for Cassidy. Abby Dimitrovich of Ontonagon also brought her short game to the D3 final as the ball would stop within about 2 feet of the cup. Mid-Penn's Hunter Brandstrom pulled out her putter from off the green, and she's told me that she didn't like to chip the ball, and you don't need to chip the ball when you putt like that. Hunter finished in fourth place with a 95. Looking at the girls' team scores, Bark River Harris wins the title with a collective team score of 415. Forest Park finished in second, and Ontonagon in third. At the UP Division II Golf Finals today at the George Young Golf Course in Iron County, Hancock won the boys' title with a team score of 327. Norway and Lance both finished with 346, but the Knights won the tiebreaker to take home second place. Tristan Leaf of Lance won medalist honors for the second year in a row. Leaf fired a 78 today. Iron Mountain took home the girls' title with a score of 444. Westwood finished in second. Margot Brown of St. Ignace was the medalist today with a score of 98. Marquette Redettes honored their 6 seniors tonight at Hurley Field against Escanaba. In game number 2, the Eskimos get on the scoreboard first. Becca Piron lays down the bunt. Kelly Heller running home from third, and she beats the throw. The squeeze play put Escanaba up 1-0. Bottom of the first, Marquette executes the squeeze play to perfection. Jay Oberg lays down the bunt. Brooke Poole scores from third to tie the game. Still in the first, a fly ball to left would be caught by Ashley Cook, and she fires at home. A play at the plate. Oberg would be just there in time. She's safe. Marquette led 3-1 after one. Top of the third, Mackenzie Leisner absolutely smokes the ball to right so far that my camera went out of focus for just a second, but it would snap back in time to see Leisner round second in the pole in the third with a triple. Escanaba scored the final 5 runs of the game to win it 6-3. The Eskimos won the first game as well 4-3. Both teams begin district play downstate on Saturday.